All right, ladies and gentlemen, y'all already know what time it is. If you like the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content, and let's just get right into it. What am I forgetting? I'm forgetting some. Most importantly, if you're part of the Noti Gang, in the comments, let me see those gem stars. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Jay Easy, aka Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ, coming to you live with another video. Hey, look here, man. Look here, man. We got a lot to talk about, and we have a little time to talk about it in. Not a whole lot of news, but it is a lot to talk about. I want to get you guys' opinions on a couple of things, and we just want to see what it is that we can do to make this game great again. Make 2K great again, man. We need those shirts. Speaking of shirts, if you want one of the shirts that you've seen me on, Beast Mode activated today's shirt, leave a comment down in the link, down in the description below. Let me know your shirt size. Also, let me know what your build is in 2K, and do you feel like it's going extinct? Because our first story is just that. Also, go back and watch that jump shot video I put out last night if you haven't watched that. Let's just get right into it, man. We're gonna talk about builds that are going extinct. We're gonna talk about some glitches. Let's talk about the least thing first, My Player Nation. My Player Nation is like one of the biggest. Look, I don't get mad at 2K for anything. That whole patch was for My Player Nation and for the thing, for the rec deal, so you can qualify, the rec qualifier, all that. I get it. I understand what they were trying to do, but I just don't like when 2K does things like they did yesterday. They put out a patch for one thing, and then they don't patch something else. They allow you to believe that something else has been patched. Case in point, they allowed us to believe that the demigod glitch had been patched. What did you think? Like, but it hadn't been. 2K, did you think that we work on the honor system over here? Do you think that most of the community works on the honor system? I'm just not going to do it. Well, they said it's patched, so I'm not gonna try. What, bro? What? Like, what are you thinking when you do something like that? Like, it didn't happen at all. And then, like I said, right after that, I showed you guys that we played against demigods right after that, so it didn't work. Now, what they did patch is they patched jump shots. I think if you're using the no shot meter now, what used to happen is if you had no shot meter and you shot the ball and it was in the green zone, then it would turn green every time. And then like right now, if you have a meter, it'll turn white sometimes, even if you hit it in the green zone, and it won't show it. It'll just be a white that goes in. So that's how they give the illusion that full whites are going in at a higher rate when they really aren't. They just aren't giving you your greens. So they've done the same thing with the people that use no shot meter. It used to be if it landed in the green zone, it was green. You didn't get any full whites or any of that stuff. Now you're getting those. The shots are still going in, and they're going in at a higher rate. But just like I said, I shot like 60%, but none of my shots turned green the other day. And I was like, what's going on? And that's what they've patched. That's something that they patched. So shots are going in at a higher rate across the board, but they just changed it to where you're not gonna see the green every time you green if you turn the shot meter off. So they kind of leveled the playing field for that. That said, okay, that's fine. Patch that. But the other things that you didn't patch is just getting, look, man. We still got VC glitches in the game, right? We still got the demigod glitch in the game, right? We still got like all this other stuff, and you want to push to us, My Player Nation, and you want to push to us the qualifier. Like I said, you didn't fix the demigod glitch, and they think we work on the honor system, as in, hey, well, I'm just not gonna do it because it's not the right thing to do, and they said they fixed it, so I'm not even going to try. Don't you know you have people out there dedicated to this glitching game? They have a different glitch, and they put out one glitch, and then it's like one glitch at a time in between the patches so that they can use the glitch up until the next time you patch the game. It's crazy that y'all don't catch on to this. Look, why don't you just go back and look at all the glitch videos from last year, determine which ones are right, which ones are truthful, and then patch those things. Because let me tell you something, 2K, it's the same glitches every year. It's the same damn glitches every single year. Just like the VC glitch that's in stage right now. This glitch has been in there since the inception of stage. You just go in there and you don't have enough VC, get on the spot, and then it's gonna kick you out the game, but you still get the VC. It's like, what is that? Like, are we serious? Why is this glitch still in the game, bro? Like, the demigod glitch, they say it's been in there since 2K16. And people are telling you that it's been in there since 2K16. And we know that it's been in every iteration of 2K because it's in 2K19. If you go back and play 2K19 right now, that's all you're going to see. Shakedown did a good video on it yesterday. All you're going to see is demigods everywhere because they're done patching the game. Did you think that it wasn't going to leak back to that? Like, people can't even enjoy that game. Or maybe they can finally enjoy that game. Who knows? Hey, some people will argue that stretches with demigods anyway last year. But, hey, it is what it is. 2K, you got to do better, my guy. You have to do better. You can't sit here and expect, like, people have paid for this game, bro. And we are trying to enjoy it. People are trying to qualify for the league and change their lives. Yeah, people that take this stuff seriously. I don't take this game seriously. So when people do stuff and it's silly, I can just not play it for a week, do news videos, drop jump shot videos, and I can, you know, get my squad together. We can go find a trash park. I can get some gameplay, a week's worth of gameplay in like 2 hours, and I'm good. I don't have to play it. But you got some, and when Friday comes, people are definitely jumping ship to Call of Duty. I am, because I can do that. But some people aren't gonna be able to do that. Some people won't be able to jump ship to Call of Duty because either for financial reasons, because they might be kids and their parents only buy them one game between now and they're gonna get the rest of their stuff on Christmas, or it could be because they only can really play one game, or this is the only game that they care to play, and the experience is being ruined for them 100%. Like I said, some people are trying to join the league, trying to get a chance to join the league and change their lives. And they're not going to be able to do that. Like LD2K tweeted out, he's like, somebody was like, I'm playing against nothing but demigods in this thing, man. What's going on? And he's like, and when they complain that they're not able to qualify, then they're going to be mad. It doesn't matter. But if I lose to them, then I can't qualify. If I'm only playing against demigods and stacked teams, and I'm never going to be able to qualify. That's why I told you guys, go in there with the team that you trust, because that's all you're going to be playing against is demigods and stacked teams. And if you don't have a team that understands how to beat this nonsense, you're going to lose. And then your chances of qualifying, you could be the coldest to ever do it. No pun intended. You know, that little kid, you could be the coldest and you're not going to win if you don't have a team at this point right now, because everybody else is playing with you. I've been looking all over Twitter, see the garbagest people in the world just getting straight carried. But they'll be able to qualify. Now, they probably won't make it past the next round, but if you're not playing with a team, you're not even going to qualify. How's that fair? Like I said, this is supposed to be, they're going to end, how can you tell me that you're evaluating talent individually, but everybody that's getting picked up is playing on stacked teams? It doesn't make sense to me. It's not fair. It's never fair. It never was fair. It's never going to be fair. And some people would probably say, you know, I'm not even going to think about it. I'm not even going to try, because they know who they already want anyway. So it is what it is. I mean, you're just playing for fun at this point. They might pick up a few people, but a lot of us really believe that they already know who they want anyway. I hope I'm wrong. I hope that some of the people that are trying out for the league, that are listening to my video, I hope that you make it, because you are absolute dog. But the chances of that are happening, the chances of you getting struck by lightning and getting hypothermia and getting bitten by a polar bear and a grizzly bear in the same day. You probably win the lottery before you get picked up by the 2K League. I'm just going to be real with you. I'm just going to be as real as I can, because I don't think it's fair. It ain't cool the way that they're doing it. But, hey, it is what it is. On to my next subject, man. What else is not fair? Y'all know that my guy that I play with, Paul, I got mad love for my guy, man. I love playing with Paul, one of the best centers to ever do it. But I think that if you made a center and at 7-3 or 7-2 center, you should probably be asking 2K for your money back right now. And you know why? This is where the respect system would have come in handy for you guys. Because in the park, I'm going to give it enough. Now, look, I'm going to tell you, yeah, you might got a center right now, and he might be a dog in the park. You ain't better than Paul. I'm going to tell you that right now. And Paul feel like he can't even do nothing with his center, because the three-guard lineups are so prevalent. After the speed change, that pretty much kills centers. Like, you can't box anybody. You can't move. You can't keep up with people. You see a lot of three-guard lineups with 3 3-point shooters. Now your center got a guard space. That's cool, because if they miss, he should have the chance to get the rebound over everybody. That used to be the case. They can run a three-guard lineup. He get to the rim before everybody. Now the guards They coming out there. I mean, it really doesn't matter what bill they got. You sprint to the rim, get to the rim before them, and then get the rebound. Other than that, you can shoot threes. Like, they got three people that can shoot threes. You're forcing the center to guard space. And because he's not as fast as he used to be, acceleration is not as fast as it used to be. Now, you're pretty much useless. Now, a lot of people would probably say this happens every year in 2K. Not to this degree, though. It does happen about every year in 2K where you can get by without having a center. Like, we do get to that point. 2K16, we got to that point. It was 6'9". I had a 6'9 small forward, and I could hold centers, and I was an outside small forward. I could hold centers, I could get rebounds, and I could just beat people with IQ. 2K17, you could do the same thing as long as you weren't playing a glass cleaner. But if I played against an inside center, it didn't matter because I knew they were going to try to pound the ball to him. They were going to get twos. We were going to get threes. 2K18, you needed a center. But you could use, I used a two-way three-point shooter. But if they had an inside center, you were in trouble. Especially if they had a pure glass cleaner, which you didn't see much of. But you could get by with that. 2K19, you could use small forwards and pure locks. I think that's where we really started seeing that, where you could use small forwards and pure locks. Right now, I'm seeing, like my boy T said, we're seeing three offensive threats beat people just because they're completely exploiting the center. Because If you do exploit the center, you try to run a pick and roll, get the center on them, you're going to get 2 points, but they don't care because they're going to get three. Your center will inevitably not be able to keep up with them, and they're going to just manufacture threes off of the third guy running around, whoever the center's guard. It's crazy. Like, that's why I feel like when people were calling for the speed change, I was like, bro, your center is going to be slow too. Like, you don't want the speed change. Like, I get it. I understand that we needed a speed gap and a speed dip, but not like this, bro. Like, some center, you feel like you're running pick and roll, you feel like your center can't even move. Let me know if you run center and, like, well, if you're running rec and real pro-am and stuff, obviously your center's still good. It's still going to be perfect. But if you primarily play park and you play center and you're not 6'9", 6'10", 6'11", or something like that, your days might be numbered, my guy. Especially if you can't shoot threes, because like outside centers are now coming in. The three guard system is now coming in. Two guards and a small forward are now coming in. Like, it's really getting to the point where centers are probably going to be obsolete in the park. I could be wrong. I hope I'm wrong. I hope they do something to help the centers out a little bit. But the days of domination are, in the beginning of the game, it was inside center, so it didn't matter because everybody had an inside center. You had to find a way around it. But now, whew, it's getting ugly, man, because you're pulling the center on the perimeter. The center can't help. And then they're going to get, man, it's so crazy. Your center's going to be on the perimeter. He can't help. And nobody got any inside defense, so that's an automatic two for them every time also. And they can manufacture a three, whereas you can't even manufacture a three because they're just going to double-team your guard. And hey, center, go ahead. You can score it up because you're going to get two. We're going to get three. It is what it is, man. Y'all just let me know if y'all see the park migrating toward that, because I'm definitely seeing that. I feel like if you made it, like, this is where the respect system should have been. You should be able to go back and be like, yeah, this ain't getting it right now, my guy. This ain't the wave. Let me go change it. We need that, man. They need to let us put some respect on it, because when you make changes that change the game fundamentally, that make other people's bills useless, you owe those people. You can't just expect people to pay $50 more with all these games coming out. Like, I'm gonna pay $50 just to make another bill when you told me I'd be able to respect this bill in the first place. Maybe you don't want to remake your center. Maybe you just want to make him 6'11". You see what I'm saying? Maybe you just want to make him a little bit lighter so he's a little bit faster. I don't want to have 30 in the beginning. 30 speed was cool, but now 30 speeds, you can't even keep up with anybody. We're gonna run circles around you, but it is what it is. Y'all let me know what you guys think down in the comments. I guess that's why people are doing demigods, because they made it sound like, no, I can't even blame you. Now you probably gonna get tracked and banned, but hey, I can't even blame you, my guy, because when somebody tells you one thing and then they do something else, what you expect people to do? Be honest? How can we be honest with you when you weren't honest with us? That's a brain teaser for you. Anyway, man, on to the next thing. Speaking of being honest, last but not least, we got the L of the day. WR Pro-Am League. First of all, I'm thinking about making a pro-am league. Probably gonna start with like six or eight teams or something like that. We're gonna call it the Easy Premier League, the EPL, you know, the original EPL. If y'all think I should do that right there, and you know, I can have those games as part of the show, y'all let me know down in the comments, man. If you got a team, say I got a team. Also let me know your shirt size. And so you can have a chance to win one of these shirts. 500 likes, we're giving away a shirt. We didn't make 500 likes yesterday. Make 500 likes today and go make the video from yesterday, get it. Anyway, the following player, OhMyOn, PSN OhMyOn, was shown to have glitch tendencies, including zero foul tendencies when reviewing footage. Therefore, he has been banned from further competition in the WGS Invitational and has one full season banned from WR beginning now. Dang! And then said, how you guys going to say he's good and then ban him? Dude says, so you're saying you support cheating? Doesn't matter when we caught it, it's caught. Yeah, just like I say, if I stole this money 10 years ago and they caught me, you're still going to jail, baby. And then said, honestly, I would like for you guys to explain how it is cheating if those tendencies I have in my career, why are you trying to make me an example when there's actual demigods running around the leagues? You can't get mad if you get caught first, my brother. You got caught, OhMyOn69. Stop snitching, you got caught. Take your punishment like a man, you know you did it. Bro, they got ways to... OhMyOn69, it's other people there. It's other people out here stealing stuff, and I'm stealing this bread for my kids. But it's other people out there robbing whole banks. Why you not catching it? Because we didn't catch them. It's just like your mama used to say, I ain't catch them, they ain't my kids. I caught you, so you got to deal with it. That's just how it go, man. Come on, man. If you engage in high risk activity, you know that it's high risk for a reason. If you don't know what the tendencies glitch is, people are claiming that they're better than what they are. You got locks out here running around with zero fouls, and that's why they can reach on you and reach on you and reach on you and never foul you, but they always get a steal. You got people out here running around with their tendencies, with their layup tendencies to zero and their dunk tendencies to 100. That's why they're going to the rim on you and punching every time when your guy does foo-foo layups. They got centers that just catch the ball in the paint with 2 feet and just cram that. And one. They doing that every single time. Meanwhile, our centers doing foo-foo layups over guards. Them weak-ass layups. That's what we doing. But they got sharpshooters going to the rim. And one. Like, come on, man. We always knew that the competitive level of 2K is where the most chicanery goes on. I just think this adds more validity to my claim. I'm not saying that everybody does it, because I got a lot of people that I know that play competitive and play comp, and they play in the WR leagues and stuff like that, and they don't cheat, and they absolutely abhor cheating and stuff like that. But I know it's a lot more that are doing things like this. Now, are they going to ban the whole league? Are they going to find everybody? Hey, they have to. It doesn't matter. It's just like if you got somebody in the NFL or NBA or whatever, and they pee hot, and they get a dirty urine sample, a hot urine sample. They can be like, well, everybody else in the NFL is smoking weed. And yeah, that's true. But they knew when the test was coming and they avoided it. And so they might pee hot. They might have a dirty sample. But guess what? They avoided it. It is what it is. You can't get mad when you get caught. That's the rules, man. If you're cheating, if you're doing anything, you can't try to be like, well, every other criminal in the world should get caught too. They probably will. Their time is coming. You just were first. Can't get mad when you first, bro. But anyway, it is what it is. Y'all let me know what y'all think about that. Did y'all think the stuff like this is going on all the time when you play like high comp, pro-am and stuff like that? I've always known that, like I said, that those guys are the biggest cheesers, the biggest people that know how to exploit every animation, know how to exploit everything in the game. That's what me and Coyote have always said. That at the highest level, it's not skill anymore to some degree. To some degree, they just know how to exploit the game more than the next person, and they are committed to that cheese. Just like going to stage. Those guys, mechanically, they may not be better than you, but they know every animation, every exploit, everything. They know how to freeze your player so you can't move. I know how to not get froze, though, because I've been messing with some of the settings, and we got to test that out later. But I know how to do it. I got some stuff for y'all. These defensive backs is going to be ready. But look, they, you know, it is what it is. A lot of those guys are good of their own volition, of their own merit, but a lot of them, it's just as many that aren't. And they will take any advantage to stick out. But anyway, like I said, but if he didn't do it, I hope he didn't do it. I hope he gets exonerated. But if he did do it, hey, take your band, hush your mouth, and, you know, don't want everybody else to get caught just because you got caught, man. That's a bitch move. I'm sorry. It just is what it is. It ain't no other word for it. I couldn't think of no other way to explain that. You can't start bitching when you get caught. When you get caught, just take your time, brother. If me and you rocking together and you get and I get caught and you don't, then I'm gonna take the time, and that's cool. Now, if you didn't tell me that you fully intended to rob this store when I got in the car with you, and you go in there, and I thought we were just going to get some Cheeto cheesy puffs, you know, the hot Cheeto fireballs and stuff, and I'm going in there to get my cheesy puffs, and you go, oh, dog on the dude, and pull your pistol, I'm out. And when they tell, and they ask me, I'm snitching. They ain't even snitching, I'm telling. I ain't going to jail for nobody unless we agreed that we were going into it before together, like we both in this together, and then you got caught and I got caught and you didn't, I ain't telling. But if I ain't know nothing about the plan, you damn right I'm not going to jail. I'm telling Bridget, you better not never do no crime. Hey, if you get caught and you didn't tell me and I didn't agree to it, hey, you going to jail, partner. And I'm telling, I'm not even taking the amendment to not have to testify against my wife. I'm testifying. I'm snitching. As they need his daddy. Don't drop the song. Anyway, man, I gotta get up out of here, man. Y'all let me know what y'all think about this. Do you think that's where most of the cheating and cheese goes on in the 2K community or what? This video been too long, man. I gotta get up out of here. Let me know if you think centers are going extinct. If they're not extinct already, will they be extinct in another month? In the park. Let me know your shirt size. Let me know if you think that's where a lot of the cheating goes on. And just let me know if you know of any other glitches out there. Thanks to everybody that told me that I did play against those demigods and how it happened and all that good stuff, man. But I got to get up out of here. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And until next time, it's your boy Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Godspeed.